Hi, I'm Aaron with Point Zero Energy, and I'm here today with our company's founder and owner, David. And we've had a lot of questions lately about batteries. So Dave, when we're looking at batteries, what kind of things should we pay attention to and be looking for?
Yeah, Aaron, that's a good question. We have a lot of people that have questions about batteries and what they should look for. For a portable power station, there's really four main key areas you want to look at: energy density, longevity, cost, and safety. And we'll just kind of go over each one of those a little bit so we can talk about it and what batteries are the best for those.
Yeah, what's energy density?
Yeah, energy density, what is it? So here's a couple of batteries here. This one is a 200 amp hour battery, and this battery here is a 75 amp hour battery.
Big difference in size.
Try picking them up.
Yep, that's a solid battery. Well, a lot lighter.
So that's energy density. It's how much energy a battery will store per amount of weight, how heavy it is. So if it's extremely light and can hold a lot of energy, it has a very high energy density.
And that's good.
That is great, especially for a portable system, because would you want to be carrying this around with you, or would you rather be carrying this around with you?
It's obvious.
So energy density is very important in a portable system. For portable power stations, there's really three different types of batteries. One is like this, which is a lead acid battery. Hardly anybody uses those anymore because they are so heavy. And we'll talk about other things, but these just aren't very good for a portable power station. This is a lithium battery. This is specifically lithium iron phosphate, which is one of the heavier lithium batteries. This is a NMC, nickel magnesium cobalt battery, which is actually a lot higher density than this one. This doesn't have as much power as that, but it does have a higher energy density.
All right, so from what you said, it seems like this NMC battery has the best energy density, but how does that relate to these other two batteries with the other aspects that you mentioned previously?
That's a very good question. If is all we were considering is energy density, the NMC would be the battery of choice. And that's actually the battery we use in our current Titan. In our next Titan, we're gonna have the lithium iron phosphate as an option as well. And that's mainly due to this next one, which is longevity. When you look at how long they last, that's also important. You don't want a battery that you use and you have to replace it every year, which the lead acid battery, if you're recycling those all the time, you have to replace them a lot more often.
Right, in my car, I'm buying one every couple years, it feels like, and I don't wanna do that with my portable power station.
Exactly. The lead acid battery is only gonna last you 3 to 5 years. They do make some really heavy duty ones for off grid that'll last a lot longer, but they're even way heavier than those, and so their energy density is even lower. The lithium iron phosphate has actually a lot longer life than the NMC battery. It'll typically last 3 to 5,000 cycles as opposed to this NMC, which is typically about 500 cycles. So it does last quite a bit longer. Now, one thing to note is in our Titan, we actually only use part of the cycle. So we can get up to 2,000 cycles out of one of these NMC batteries, which is almost as much as a lithium iron phosphate.
So when you fully charge a battery and then fully discharge it down to zero, you really are kind of killing the battery and shortening the lifespan of the battery. So we want to stop using the battery at a low percentage and recharge at that point, and it'll have a longer lifespan.
Yeah. And one interesting thing, a lot of people are so used to lead acid batteries, you always want to keep them full. You never want them to drain or they get ruined. Well, lithiums are kind of different than that. In fact, you don't want to keep them totally full either. The mid-range, if you cycle them in the mid-range, you can get 10 times the cycles out of them, or even more if you use that mid-range as opposed to just keeping them fully charged all the time. And so with our unit, we don't fully charge it to the 100% capacity of the battery. And so that does give us some life, but these will still last longer. So in the longevity area, the lithium iron phosphate does outlast the NMC.
So now with these batteries, there's got to be a difference in cost. One's more expensive, less expensive. I'm sure there's a huge range of costs.
As a general rule, the lead acid batteries are the cheapest per amount of energy storage. But when you put in the life of the battery, because their life is so much shorter, the lithiums are actually a better deal. You actually get a better value out of them because they will last so many more cycles than the lead-based batteries.
So I'm almost gonna buy two of these batteries to equal the life of this one, which then makes it so that the overall cost is more.
At least two, two, three, maybe four times, depending on how much you're using them.
Yeah, that's a big difference.
Yeah, so it is. These are actually a better value than those. Even though you might look at the upfront cost, you know, one of these may cost you $100 and one of these might be $300, but this is actually a better value over the long run.
Okay, so what kind of safety measures are in place with the Titan and other portable power stations to prevent a hazardous situation with the battery?
Yeah, well, pretty much any lithium battery comes with what's called a BMS, or battery management system.
Okay.
And so we can program them to whatever. We program ours so that if it's getting charged too quickly, it'll shut off the battery to protect it from overheating.
Makes sense.
If for some reason the battery gets over 120 degrees, it shuts off the battery so that it won't get any hotter.
Under normal circumstances for portable power station like the Titan, our current NMC battery is incredibly safe. It's the right balance of weight to energy storage. We have a lot of life cycles because we've built it and designed it to charge and discharge in the correct range for longevity. It's just, for right now, it's a great all-around battery. So I've seen a lot of marketing and advertising lately for lithium iron phosphate batteries. What's the movement, or what's the purpose that's becoming a hot topic?
The two things they really promote with those is the longevity, because okay, they do last longer than the NMC battery. And especially if you're using the full cycle, you know, fully charging them, fully draining them, it will outlast the NMC by quite a bit. The other one is safety.
So for people who are using a portable power station every so often in emergency preparedness and when they go camping, either of these batteries would work awesome.
Yeah.
For people who are using their power station on a consistent, daily, regular basis, the lithium iron phosphate will give them a little bit more life to their battery.
Yeah, yeah, and especially if they don't plan on moving it. So if it's like for their home or their cabin, and it's like,
correct,
it's not gonna move, but I'm gonna be cycling those batteries every day, be using them all the time, then yeah, lithium iron phosphate is the choice there.
So Dave, we talked about the NMC battery and a lithium iron phosphate. They both have benefits. Some are better in certain situations, short-term use, long-term fixed use. What plans does Point Zero Energy have with their batteries?
So we currently have the NMC battery in our current Titan, and we're planning on releasing a lithium iron phosphate battery that will actually be compatible with our current Titan, as well with some future versions.
Well, Dave, we've had a good educational discussion today. We at Point Zero Energy recognize the importance of education. There's a lot of questions. There's a lot of differences. There's a lot of different products out on the market, and we want to educate you about our products and any other questions that you may have with portable power stations. So Dave, let's have more chats.
Sounds good.
Okay.